how pancreatic secretion gets regulated. It is mostly regulated hormonally. How? You can observe in this diagram, when the concentration of fatty acids and the amino acids increase in the lumen of the intestines, it means when the food or the chyme has entered from the stomach into duodenum, the amount of digested fatty material and the digested protein material is getting raised in the lumen of intestine. The presence of these materials is leading for the secretion of a hormone from the small intestine that is called as CCK. The CCK via blood or plasma is approaching the pancreas, and from the pancreas it is responsible to raise which content of the pancreatic juice? Enzymatic content of the pancreatic juice. So the flow of enzyme via pancreatic juice into the small intestine gets increased, and these enzymes are then responsible to digest the fats and proteins. As soon as the digestion will increase, the concentration of these fatty acids and amino acids will decrease, and this will work in a negative feedback mechanism. In this display, you are observing that the acid from the stomach has approached the intestine, and in the intestine, the acidic scenario has been increased. The acidic chyme has entered the small intestine or the duodenum, and this acidity is responsible to release a hormone that is called as secretin from the small intestine. This secretin via blood and plasma approaches the pancreas, specifically the pancreatic ductal cells, and from there it is responsible to increase which secretion? Bicarbonate secretion, or the aqueous component of the pancreatic juice. So the flow of bicarbonate into small intestine gets increased, and this bicarbonate is then responsible to neutralize the intestinal acidic scenario, to neutralize the intestinal acidic environment. As soon as this will get neutralized, the stimulus for the release of further secretin will get inhibited. Some more words about it. You can observe in this diagram that as the food has entered into a small intestine, it has led to the secretion of a hormone that is secretin, and it has led to the secretion of a hormone that is CCK, cholecystokinin. Now, we find out some details about these two hormones. First, about secretin. Secretin is a hormone, polypeptide in nature, with 27 amino acids. Secretin is released from the S cells, which are located among the epithelial cells of the mucous membrane of duodenum and jejunum. So the source of secretin is the existence of S cells in duodenum and jejunum. The most potent stimulus for the release of secretin is a low pH, pH less than 3 up to 4.5. It means when the acidic food enters from the stomach into duodenum, it is responsible to decrease the pH of the duodenum and jejunum. And this low pH or acidic environment in the duodenum and jejunum is responsible for the release of secretin by S cells. Secretin is released in an inactive form, prosecretin, which is converted into its active form, secretin, by the presence of HCl and the salts of fatty acid which are present in the chyme in the intestinal lumen. Secretin then via blood approaches the pancreas, and it mostly works on the ductal cells of the pancreas. It works with the help of a second messenger, and its second messenger is cyclic AMP. And via working through this second messenger, it is responsible to produce a huge amount of watery pancreatic juice having a high concentration of bicarbonate, having about 145 to 150 milliequivalents of bicarbonate per liter. It means such pancreatic juice is released under the influence of secretin, which is watery in nature and is having a very high alkaline nature also. The reason of such pancreatic juice, the function of such pancreatic juice is, number one, to neutralize that HCl which has approached along with chyme from the stomach into intestinal lumen. So in this way, it protects the intestinal mucosa from being damaged by this acid. And number two, it provides a required pH, an alkaline pH between 7 to 9 for the activation of pancreatic enzymes. It means the pancreatic enzymes work optimally not in acidic environment but only in highly alkaline environment. So the duodenal and jejunal environment has to be converted from the acidic environment into alkaline environment so that the pancreatic enzyme should show their performance of digestion. Other actions of the secretin are like, it also stimulates bile secretion. It potentiates the effect of CCK on pancreas. It means it helps out the effect of CCK also. It works in collaboration with the CCK to produce an optimal secretion of pancreatic juice. Along with CCK, it is also responsible to cause the contraction of pyloric sphincter. It means it is responsible for causing a delay in gastric emptying and thus preventing the reflux of duodenal contents back into stomach. So in this way, the secretin is released out and is working on the pancreatic secretion. Now, some words about CCK. CCK is also a polypeptide containing about 33 amino acids. CCK is released from an other cell that is called as I cells. These I cells are also located among the epithelial cells of the mucosa of duodenum and jejunum. These I cells are responsible to release out CCK when sufficient amino acids, specifically phenylalanine and the long chain fatty acids and monoglycerides, are present in the lumen of duodenum and jejunum. So these are the stimulants for the release of CCK from I cells. CCK, from its site of release, via blood approaches to the pancreas. CCK mainly affects the acinar cells. CCK causes the secretion of pancreatic juice, which is rich in enzymes, by causing the discharge of all zymogen granules from the pancreatic acinar cells. It also works via second messenger system. And the second messenger which helps this hormone is IP3, inositol phosphate 3. Now, what are the other actions of CCK? CCK is responsible for the contraction of gallbladder to release bile. Number two, it potentiates the effect of secretin to produce more alkaline pancreatic juice. It increases the secretion of enterokinase from the duodenum. It inhibits the gastric motility. It increases the motility of small and large intestine. It is also involved to certain extent in the maintenance of pancreatic growth. So it is also having some trophic action on pancreas. Secretin potentiates the effect of CCK. By itself, secretin has no effect on enzyme secretion in the pancreatic juice. In the same way, CCK potentiates the effect of secretin, but by itself, CCK has no effect on ductal cells to increase the bicarbonate secretion. Because both of the two are potentiating each other's action, so small concentrations of CCK and secretin together can produce significant amounts of pancreatic bicarbonate and also enzymatic secretions. Further, a vagovagal reflex does get initiated during this phase of digestion. This is intestinal phase of digestion. This reflex greatly potentiates the effects of secretin and CCK through release of acetylcholine. So we can say that vagal stimulation is more potent in stimulating pancreatic secretions when CCK and secretin are present in plasma. Now, in this diagram, you can also observe that secretin is approaching the pancreas to release out aqueous juice which is rich in water and bicarbonate content. CCK is approaching pancreas to release the juice which will be heavily loaded with pancreatic enzyme variety. And here you can see that the CCK is also responsible to potentiate the effect of secretin. In this way, the pancreatic secretion, when the food has entered the duodenum and jejunum, is regulated more predominantly by these two hormones than the neural regulation. How the two secretions, bile and pancreatic secretion mechanism, are correlated with each other and are observed at the same time. In the number one, the food has entered from the stomach into duodenum. The chyme is entering the duodenum and is causing the duodenal enteroendocrinal cells, S cells, to release secretin and I cells to release CCK. The CCK is shown as red dots and the secretin is shown as yellow dots. Now, both these hormones, after getting released from the duodenal mucosa, are gaining entrance into blood. Now, via blood, they are approaching the pancreas. CCK at number 3, you can observe. The CCK is responsible to induce the secretion of enzyme-rich pancreatic juice. It means CCK is working at acinar cells to release out more and more enzymes, while the secretin is approaching the ductal cells at the same time and is responsible to cause the pancreatic juice, which is rich in bicarbonate. Now, at number 4, you can observe that bile salts and to a lesser extent secretin transported via blood are responsible to stimulate liver to produce more bile rapidly. Rapidly means when the food is present in a small intestine. These are the stimuli which currently are compelling liver to produce more and more bile rapidly. Now, at number 5, you can observe that the CCK via blood at this time has approached gallbladder, and CCK here is responsible to do another job, that is to contract the gallbladder, make the gallbladder to squeeze out its stored bile, and further it is responsible to relax the sphincter of Oddi, or we can also call it as hepatopancreatic sphincter. Relaxation of this sphincter at the same time is responsible for a rapid flow of bile more from the stored gallbladder, and also directly, which is coming from the liver directly into duodenum. So more and more bile at this moment is gaining entrance into duodenum. Number 6, during cephalic and gastric phases, vagal nerve also stimulates gallbladder to contract, but very weakly. This weak contraction is not of great significance, but the strong contraction, which is promoted by the approach of CCK, and this is more important as it is responsible for the maximal release of stored bile in the duodenum. Why? Because multiple materials, multiple fats, carbohydrates, proteins, all nutrients are present in the intestine now, which need the presence of those materials which should be responsible to digest them away. So in this way, in this diagram, we do come to know that when the food has entered into duodenum, the approach of bile and the approach of pancreatic juice, both are significant at this moment, and in this way the two secretions are getting potentiated with each other also. What are the functions of the pancreatic juice? The pancreatic juice performs only two functions. Number one, the function of digestion. As you all know now, that pancreatic juice is the major source of group of digestive enzymes. It has the group which is called as lipases, the group which is called as amylases, and proteases. So it has the enzymes which have the capability to digest away all the three major nutrients of the entered food. So the pancreatic juice is responsible for the digestion of all these three materials. The second function of the pancreatic juice is the neutralizing function, because now you know that one component of the pancreatic juice make the pancreatic juice highly alkaline, that is a high concentration of bicarbonate, and this high concentration of bicarbonate is responsible to neutralize the gastric HCl in the chyme which has entered from the stomach into duodenum. What are the phases of pancreatic secretion? Though both neural and hormonal mechanisms are involved in the regulation of pancreatic secretion, but the hormonal regulation becomes more predominant. The neural regulation is through vagal efferent fibers, which supply the exocrine pancreas, both the acinar cells and the ductal cells. And the hormonal regulation is through secretin hormone, CCK hormone, gastrin hormone, and somatostatin hormone. Now, first phase is called as the cephalic phase. 20% of the pancreatic secretion can be observed in this phase. Cephalic phase is observed when the food has not entered into stomach. This phase is characterized by very little flow of the pancreatic juice. This phase is regulated only by nervous route. The reflex vagal stimulation is responsible for the existence of this secretion or this phase secretion. This vagal stimulation can get initiated by conditioned reflexes like by sight, smell, or thought of food or hearing about food. Such conditioned reflexes can stimulate the vagal nerve, which is then responsible to enhance minutely the pancreatic secretion. Or it can also get stimulated by some unconditioned reflexes like by the taste buds when the food is present in mouth, or by the activity of chewing and swallowing. The enzymatic secretion from the acinar cells is enhanced due to the stimulation of enteric neurons, which release acetylcholine, and this acetylcholine exerts its effect on the acinar cells by activating phospholipase. Similarly, the bicarbonate secretion from the ductal cells is also enhanced by the stimulation of enteric neurons, which release the transmitter. Now, the other phase, or the next phase, is the gastric phase. The gastric phase of the pancreatic secretion occurs when the stomach gets distended by food. It means this phase is observed when the food is present in stomach. This phase is regulated by neural control to some extent, and to some extent by a hormone that is called as gastrin. During this phase, vasovagal reflex, which gets initiated due to the distension of the body of stomach by food, it results in the secretion of a very low volume of pancreatic juice, which contains both bicarbonate and enzymatic part in a very low amount. the G cells in this situation get stimulated, and the G cells in the pyloric part of the stomach are responsible to release out gastrin. This gastrin via blood approaches the pancreas and stimulates the acinar cells to produce a very low volume but high enzymatic pancreatic secretion. The third phase is called as the intestinal phase. And this is the phase when the food has approached in intestine, and which we have currently discussed in detail, that the presence of food in the intestine is responsible for the release of two hormones dominantly, one the secretin and other the cholecystokinin. And these two are working on the exocrine pancreas to release out a pancreatic juice which is rich in enzymes and also rich in bicarbonate or aqueous component of the pancreatic juice. The most common pathology related to the pancreas is pancreatitis. It is a common condition. It can present itself in acute as well as also in chronic presentations. Acute pancreatitis is an acute inflammatory disease of the pancreas. It is thought to result from autodigestion of the pancreatic tissue by the proteolytic enzymes, which leak out of the acini and are activated within the vicinity of pancreas. Recently, it has been hypothesized that the proteolytic enzymes become activated by lysosomal hydrolysis within the pancreatic acini itself. Patient usually presents with acute pain in the upper abdomen, nausea, and vomiting. It is a serious disease and may be fatal sometimes. Chronic pancreatitis is a chronic inflammation of pancreas, which results in slow destruction of the pancreatic tissue, and it results in the deficiency of multiple pancreatic enzymatic secretions. Patients with extensive destruction of the pancreas may develop diabetes mellitus due to destruction of endocrine pancreas, which results in the deficiency of insulin. We currently are concerned that multiple digestive disturbances take place due to the deficiency of pancreatic enzymes, because we know that the pancreatic juice is loaded with a variety of enzymes which are involved in the digestion of all the three main nutrients. When the enzymatic content becomes deficient, definitely the digestion of the different nutrients become deficient. The most commonly affected is the fat metabolism, because pancreatic lipase is the dominating lipase involved in the metabolism of fat. The disturbed fat metabolism results in a condition that is called as steatorrhea, which is characterized by bulky, foul smelling, pale and greasy stools. Why? Because there is an increased amount of fat in the fecal content. As the fat is not getting digested or absorbed, so it is getting excreted out in sufficient amounts in the fecal content. And this condition is called as steatorrhea. And in this way, the multiple digestive problems can develop and can lead to the different deficiency diseases.